My name is Samir Singh, and I'm a technical marketing engineer in the NetSec team at Cisco. In this video, we will look at how to migrate site-to-site and remote access VPN configuration from Palo Alto firewalls to Cisco Secure Firewall. First, let's take a look at the site-to-site VPN migration. The migration tool will migrate the VPN tunnel as point-to-point network topology on FTD. Prerequisites include the FMC and FTD should be 6.7 or above, and FTD should be added to FMC. The PAN firewall should be version 8.0 or above. The trust point should be manually migrated to FMC as PKI objects as part of the pre-migration activity. So we begin by logging into the tool and select Palo Alto Network configuration from the list of firewalls, click on Next, and upload the source configuration to the tool. The tool parses the configuration and displays the number of site-to-site VPN tunnels along with other features that are present in the config. Next, enter the FMC detail so the tool can connect to it and select the target FTD from the list of available FTD. Under Select feature, we can see site-to-site VPN tunnel present. PAN does not support policy-based VPN, so only route-based VPN is selected. Proceed and start the conversion. The pre-migration report contains information of the number of site-to-site VPN tunnels that are available in the configuration. The report also shows the list of policies with deprecated DH groups used for users to review and make changes in FMC. Once the pre-migration report is verified, move on to map the interfaces from source firewall to target firewall along with the mapped name. Validate and then create the security zones mapped to the PAN interfaces using the auto-create option. In the Review and Validate page, navigate to the Site-to-Site VPN Tunnels tab. It provides the list of tunnels with the source interface on the device, remote peer, policy name, and the protected network of the tunnel. It provides the list of tunnels with the source interface on the device, remote peer, policy name, and the protected network of the tunnel. The tool provides the option to add pre-shared key against each VPN tunnel. Some factors considered are the multiple DH group selection is not supported in FMC, so by default, the first DH group is considered for migration. In case of multiple authentication and encryption configured, the tool will create separate policies. Once updated, validate the config. Once going through the validation summary, we can go ahead and push the configuration to the target device. We can download the post-migration report from the tool and verify the different configuration migrated by the tool, including the site-to-site VPN configuration, the deprecated DH groups, and the site-to-site VPN policies that are migrated by the tool. On the target device, we can see the different policies that are created. We can further drill down into them and see the different configuration associated with each policies, which match with what was configured on PAN. Now let's take a look at remote access VPN configuration migration. prerequisites include that FMC should be 7.2 and FTD should be 7.0 or above, and FTD should be added to FMC. The PAN firewall should be version 8.0 or above. The trust point should be manually migrated to FMC as PKI objects as part of the pre-migration activity. The process begins with uploading the PAN configuration to the tool, and the tool lists the different features present in the configuration. Click on Next and provide the target FMC details. Once entered, the tool will list the available FTDs and then select the target FTD. Select the FTD and proceed. The RAVPN feature will be present under the shared configuration. Click on Proceed and Start Conversion to begin the conversion process. Once complete, it will provide a pre-migration report containing details of the configuration, including the RAVPN details. Next, map the PAN firewall interfaces with the threat defense interfaces. Following this, we'll map the interfaces with the security zones on FTD. In this case, we will use auto-create option to create the security zones that will be mapped to the PAN interfaces. If there are any applications that need to be mapped between PAN and Secure Firewall, it will appear on this page. Under the Optimize Review and Validate page, the tool will point out the sections that require user inputs. In the Remote Access VPN section, all objects corresponding to Remote Access VPN are migrated from Palo Alto Networks Firewall to Management Center and are displayed. Policy Assignment. It reviews and validates the connection profiles, their VPN protocols, targeted device, and the names of the VPN interfaces. These names can be renamed in the tool. IQ2 shows the IQ2 protocol configuration and the source interface mapped with them. AnyConnect packages and AnyConnect profiles should be retrieved from the source device and must be available for migration. As part of the pre-migration activity, upload all AnyConnect packages to the management center. You can select pre-existing AnyConnect host scan or external browser packages retrieved from the management center. You must select at least one AnyConnect package. You must select host scan, DAP, .xml, data.xml, or external browser if available in the source configuration. AnyConnect profiles are optional. You must upload and select all the required files for validation. Failure to update will be marked as incomplete, and the Secure Firewall Migration tool will not proceed with validation. Address pool shows all the IPv4 and IPv6 pools that are available in the configuration. The group policy section shows the group policies with client profiles, management profiles, client modules, and group policies without profiles. Connection profile. It shows all the connection profiles that are available in the configuration. Trust point or PKI object migration from PAN firewall to management center is part of the pre-migration activity and is required for successful migration of RAVPN. Map the trust point for global SSL IQ2 and interface in the remote access interface section to proceed with the next step of migration. If a SAML object exists, trust points for SAML, identity provider, and service provider can be mapped in the SAML section. Service provider certificate is optional. Trust point can also be overridden for a specific tunnel group. After complete, click on validate. It will review the existing object on FMC and compare those objects which are being migrated, and if there are any conflicts, it will resolve them on the tool itself. Then push the configuration onto the FMC. Review the post-migration report to verify the migrated VPN objects that are present, and the same can be validated on the FMC where the RAVPN configuration is migrated to. This brings us to the end of the video. I hope this was useful, and thank you all.